back and happy Diwali. Today is a Diwali special video and this is the look that I've come up with for this year's Diwali. I hope you enjoy this. Yes, I'm a Maharashtrian girl, so I've decided to dress up as a Marathi mulgi. I hope you like my this avatar. This nut is not real. I haven't pierced my nose, but I love nuts so much that yes, this keeps falling, and maybe you can see that in bloopers, but the struggle is so real to let this nut stay on my nose as long as the intro goes. Yeah, so if you want to see how I have achieved this look, then please keep on watching. Hi guys, welcome back and let's begin. So like always, we'll begin with the most important step of the makeup, and that is primer. Priming your face. Here I'm using Benefit Professional Primer and I will apply it only where I have open pores and on the forehead or the T-zone. Moving on to the concealer, here I'm using Maybelline's Age Rewind Concealer in the shade Medium and will apply it on the lid and all the way above to the eyebrow. Then I'm going to use this 3D brush from Sigma and will blend this concealer because this will act as an eye primer. And then I will set this concealer with a translucent setting powder. You can use any powder you have or a compact powder, but here I'm using Laura Mercier's translucent setting powder and will set it so that it will give a very smooth base and the colors will pop through. For this particular look, I will not be focusing on a single eyeshadow palette, but I will be using multiple eyeshadows from different brands. So the first type of shadow that I'm going to use is Early Bird from Makeup Geek, and this will act as a transition shape. I will be applying this with a clean blending brush, and this one is from Morphe M433. I will apply this into the crease and above the crease and blend it in a windshield wiper motion. I'll keep adding the shade so that until I get the desired intensity of this particular color. Then moving on to the next, this is Dragonfly from Makeup Geek again. This is a light mushy green kind of a shade, and with the help of a pack 204 brush, I will apply it only to the outer view of the eye and keep adding the color and blending it and keeping this entirely only to the outer V part of the eye and not bring it any further. The next shade that I'll be using as an eyeshadow base is again from PAC, and it is its Pure Pigment number 56. And with the help of a flat shader brush, I will apply it all the way from the inner corner to the center of the eye, that is almost 3/4 of the eye. Then I'm going to use this green shade from Juvia's Place Masquerade palette, which is Mali. And with the help of a Vega flat shader brush, we'll apply it only on the center of the eyelid, that is exactly above the eyeball. Now, with the help of same Vega brush, I will use this gorgeous shade Fuji from Makeup Geek, which is green but with yellowish undertone. So I'm going to apply it only on the inner corner of the eye to give that pop of a color. Now I'm just basically going to increase the intensity of the green eyeshadow. So we'll keep on adding that dragonfly color until I get the desired intensity. And we'll blend it with the same 204 brush from PAC, and this has become my all-time favorite blending brush because it's so easy and it gives a really gradient effect when I use this brush. In between, on and off, I'll be using the same brush which I used to apply the transition shade Early Bird, and will just blend the eyeshadows without taking any additional product at all, because we just want the eyeshadows to be blended and don't want to see any harsh line. Here I'm using Maybelline's Nude palette, and the black shade from this palette is what I'm going to apply only on the outer V with the help of a PAC pencil brush. Basically, I'm just applying this black shade because I felt that I wanted to have some more depth in this look. I wanted to have some more dark green effect, and so I'm just going to add that black color and blend it with the same PAC brush number 204. So I won't repeat myself, guys. Blending is the key to the perfect look, so keep blending and just keep blending. Now moving on, I'm just damping my brush with some water. Alternatively, you can also use Max Fix Plus. And basically, I'm just retouching all these eyeshadows which had lost its intensity in the whole blending process. Now, I'll be grabbing this PAC pencil brush and will use the same Dragonfly eyeshadow from Makeup Geek and the black eyeshadow from Maybelline's palette, and will apply it to the lower lash line and blend it. Now for some eyeliner, here I'm using Sigma's eyeliner brush and Inglot gel liner number 77. It is the blackest black gel eyeliner color that I've ever come across, and it's expensive, but it is my all-time favorite. And for people who are not on budget, it's definitely a must buy. Before we apply some mascara, time to curl the lashes. Now the way to use this curler is take it close to your eyelashes, press it, hold it for some time and release it. Today I will be using mascara from Too Faced. It's better than the Sex mascara. I will not say I'm really fond of this mascara, but yes, since I had it in my kitty, I just wanted to use it for this time. This look definitely calls for eyelashes, so here I'm using eyelash from pack number 54. I felt that I was recording my foundation routine, but I haven't recorded it and I'm so sorry for it. So I will just have the details mentioned in the description box below. So for this particular look, I really wanted to go for bronzing rather than contouring, and here I'm using NARS Casino Bronzer and will bronze all over my face with the help of a packed powder brush. So by now, if you have watched most of my videos, you know that this particular blush that I'm talking about is most used blush and is my all-time favorite and inseparable part of my life by now. And this is from Inglot blush number 45, and with the same powder brush and I'm applying it on my cheekbones. Now I will just dust away the translucent setting powder that I left for baking. This is a very simple eyebrow routine, and I will have the detailed link to the eyebrow tutorial mentioned in the description box below. Again, a very simple nose contouring, and for this I'll be using powder contour from Makeup Geek and a blending brush to do so. Now time for the highlighter, and here I'm using NYX's Wavy Glow liquid highlighter in the shade State of Flux. This is my recent favorite liquid highlighter, and this is the new way of highlighting my tip of the nose, and which is again my very favorite by now. Can we just take a moment, guys, and just appreciate this highlighter? Oh my god, look at the shine. As if that much highlighter wasn't enough, so I had to go back and apply this particular eyeshadow from PAC, and this is the perfect duochrome purplish pinkish eyeshadow, and which is my favorite eyeshadow from PAC. Now moving to lips, this is my favorite lipstick and lip gloss combination. Both of them are from ColourPop. The liquid lipstick is Chi liquid lipstick and the liquid gloss is Veho, and this is by far my favorite combination. I just felt that the whole look was a little bit washing me out, so I went back and applied this lip liner from L'Oreal, and I did apply it after applying my lipstick. So this is my finished look. I hope you all liked it. If you want to see more such festival appropriate looks, then please stay tuned. If you like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up. If you're new to our channel, then do subscribe, because more such interesting festival appropriate looks are going to be up on our channel soon. So here's wishing you and your family a very lovely and safe Diwali and a prosperous new year. Play with firecrackers, but in limits. Don't forget the pollution part of it. Until my next video. Bye-bye.